guys, welcome back to another Ark Survival The Centaur Xbox map. Welcome. So, I was going to take a bit of a break and do some stuff offline before we did the next video, but I had an excellent idea, and these guys are going to help me do it. This is a little bit of a cluster of Brontos that seems to have gathered. I'm just across the lake from the pub. That's just over there. Got a nice little stego hanging out as well. And I'm going to steal some poop off these guys, because what I was going to do sort of offline between episodes, I was going to go and tame a Fiomia to get to get poop to make fertilizer with. Ooh, just got those. Because I thought I wouldn't really be able to get a dung beetle yet, because I don't have an arge to pick one. But then I remembered the grapple. So what I reckon I can do is go and grapple one and bring it back on the Pteranodon. Although, come to think of it, there is actually a cave entrance very close by, so I might go and have a quick poke my head in the cave and see if I can see any dung beetles in there, and if not, I might fly over to Skull Island. Or maybe we'll go to Skull Island first, actually. Oh my god, there's so many Brontos around here. I mean, this is great for me. I'm just grabbing there. If you've not tamed dung beetles before, you tame them using poop, and large poop is the most effective. There are... Oh, I missed that one. There are so many Brontos here. Holy crap. So three there. There was a cluster of three where I was. Whose house is this? Oh, Ronnie. Dodo's United. Hey, guys. What's up? Not much. Got another one over there. Oh, God, what's that? Is that a... Oh, no, it's a trike. Another one over there. Oh, this is great. So the large poops are the most effective for taming dung beetles, so that's very handy for me to have some large dinos. What is this? Someone doing a bit of taming? A little taming pen going on? That is Ratleg. Ah, oh, what's up, Sophie? How you doing? Hello. What are you taming there, mate? Nice little Pteranodon. Very nice. Very nice. Oh, God. I've attracted some bugs. Go. Hopefully none of those are going to go in there and mess up your Pteranodon. Right. Anyway. Oh, God. Is that... I thought it was an angry beaver. It's not. It's just a beaver. That's fine. Right, let's go and grab a couple more poops. I don't think we'll need too many because of the taming speed. As long as we find a dung beetle that's not crazy high level, we should be okay. Oh, that's not a poop. That's its foot. I just want to grab one or two more poops. One other thing I want to show you this episode, and that's going to be... I mentioned before about being able to paint your stuff, being able to colour your items. There's another one. Nice. Any colour you like without having to make the dyes properly, which is pretty handy. So I'm going to show you that in just a minute. I'm just going to have a quick look and see how many poops are different level Brontos will take, and then we'll crack on with the dying. Oh, hello, an anklo. Nice. It's nice to know you get anklos nearby as well. Very handy for metal, although mostly useful if you have a quets as well, because they're very, very slow and their carry weight's not great, so they're not much use on their own, but unless you've got them parked up by a mining shack very close to metal nodes, I guess. But really you want a quets so you can carry them around and farm metal like a madman. Anyway, let's check out our dung beetle tamings, and I'll be right back. Right, so apparently if I get 9 of these, that'll do anything level 100 or under, and I've got 7, so I think I might just try and grab two more lovely poops. Oh, a bit dehydrated. And then we'll go and grab our dung beetle. We'll do our painting, and then we'll grab our dung beetle. I actually had to remake all my stuff. I logged off after recording the last episode, not for very long. In my base, logged on, said you'd been killed by a level 135 Carno, so that Carno apparently had come back somehow and got me. I was a bit worried for a second that, hang on, which way did I go to find those other ones? Was it around here? I think it was, down there. I think what had happened is I'd glitched through the floor. That's the problem with floor ceilings on pillars, is they're really easy for your body to glitch through. And unfortunately, that seems to have happened, so I lost all of my full set of flak, my sword, my metal tools. A little bit jarring, but, you know, that's Ark. What can you do? Unfortunately, on PvE, one of the biggest dangers is Ark being a little bit buggy and dropping you through floors when you log out. So I'll have to get back in the habit of putting all my kit away when I log out. It's probably the easiest way to do it. The other solution would be... maybe go and sleep in the dino pen. I mean, I could still get killed by an arge there, but there's no risk of me falling through the floor and getting eaten by a Carno. I guess if I also maybe just fenced... Oh, a blue drop. Am I going to grab that? If no one else does. It's quite competitive, the drops around here, because obviously we've got so many players. There we go, and there is number 9. That'll do. Wonderful. Let's go and see if we can grab that blue drop before anyone else does, and then we'll do a bit of painting. But yeah, if I could fence up the bottom bit there. Ooh, a bit tired. Maybe ring round the bottom of the pillars in a way that doesn't look too crap, and then I can, if you do glitch through the floor, you'll kind of just fall down into that area and you still won't get eaten by stuff. I think that's probably a good idea. Let's go and grab this. After the terrible drops we were getting before. Well, other than that saber saddle was very nice. That apprentice pike with 106% damage was utterly troll. Ooh, a carbo saddle, very nice. I mean, not super useful for this, but on PvP that'd be a humdinger. That'd be a great one. Sadly, probably not going to use the turtle as much in this, but you never know. We might have a little PvP fun sometime. I'm trying to think of ways we can do a little bit of like organized PvP on this. It's going to be difficult because if you turn PvP mode on, obviously that you have to be very careful about what players you've got on, because if you want to do it volunteer PvP, like not everyone plays, then you have to have a lot of trust in people to not go out and troll during those moments of PvP. So I don't know, it's going to be tricky, but I'd quite like to think of a way of doing some, or we can at least, like, me and Jay can knock up some little PvP bases somewhere and have a bit of fun, turn it on for an evening every now and again and just go at each other and have a bit of a fight. That might be quite good fun. I know he'd be up for that because Jay chuffing loves a bit of PvP, and he'd probably absolutely wreck me because he is a man who knows how to shoot a gun, and I am fairly trash at it, so that should be interesting. We'll see. I'm pretty good at the old base building though, so maybe I'll be able to knock up some sort of nice little base that he can't crack into. Right, I'm going to show you where we're going to get dung beetles. We're going to go, I won't bother with the cave, we'll go over and do it at the other spot that I know, because it's a very cool spot and I think you guys all like seeing it. Let's go. We've got water, we've got a bit of food, we've got a spyglass, sword, crossbow, grapples, an inventory full of poop. Oh, I was going to paint my armor, wasn't I? Let me do that real quick. We're pretty much ready to go with that. Let's land him on the roof. Be sensible. Can never be too careful in Ark. Right. Let's go. I think I've got all the bits on me to do this, right? I've got some berries. Oh, I need to get... I put that in there. I just need to get some berries. And these ones will do. There we go. Look at that. Right, so that's all we need. We can get rid of the rest of this stuff now. Take those out, take that out. Oh, I did use that water skin as well, cool. Fine, we might as well leave the charcoal in, that doesn't really matter. So what you do is you just take your, assuming this hasn't been patched yet, it only works with things that you put into the cooking pot to colour. It doesn't work with making a paintbrush and colouring stuff like that. But all you do is select the colour and colour the item like you normally would. And then, so select a region, and it's blue. But you see, we've also got this list of all the ones that we haven't got. This is what you could have won down here. But if you actually just select one, it still colours it. And then if you go and press... Oh, what colour should we go for? Silver's kind of cool. I guess it's kind of silver anyway, though, right? Let's have a little look through. Oh, I know one. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's like bronze. That is really nice. Tangerine. Yeah, but it kind of looks bronze, so... Let's see how brick looks. What is... Oh, navy? Yeah. Brick. No, I... Oh, that slate's quite nice. Not sure about cantaloupe or mud. I think we'll go with tangerine. It looks kind of bronzy. But then if you just go down to dye item, it just dyes it. Even though you haven't got that dye, it just totally works. Which is really nice. And it doesn't even use up any of the dye. So you can see now, if I chuck this back on, just to show you that's worked. Doo-doo-doo. It's kind of hard to see because it's a bit of a funny colour, but that does... Well, I'll paint one of my bits a wacky colour and then you'll be able to see a little bit more, obviously. So let's paint this, like, I don't know, green, forest green, which is kind of a hard dye to get. So let's paint it forest green. There you go. You can actually see that in the little image here, but I'll chuck it on. And we'll go into orbit cam, and look at that. We've got our lovely bronze hat, our green armour, and no trousers on. What a look. So good tip, isn't it? One of the guys, I can't remember who it was, but a guy who plays on our PvP server showed us that one. So shout out to that guy. If you watch a lot of Ark videos, you've probably seen Jay do a video on that already, but if you haven't, then it's a handy little tip to know. So let's just paint the rest of this, tangerine real quick, and then we'll go out and get this dung beetle. Right, so there we go. I've finished dyeing my things. We've got this awesome looking bronze armor, which I really, really like. I mean, technically it's tangerine, but this looks very cool. I didn't bother putting any like accents on it. It's all tangerine, so I might check that out and change it a little bit sometime. We made the sword a sort of extra bit more silvery than normal. Nice black handle. And we've also got this fabulous looking pink club for when we need to dish out some KOs. So I'm pretty pleased with that. And I think my tools are, well, I've made a little bit more silvery than they normally are. They don't look too crazy. And the crossbow I've made kind of silver as well, but that doesn't really show up too much. But yeah, that's pretty cool little tip. So hopefully you found that useful. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to get a dung beetle. Let's do it. Right, another level in stamina. Stamina's getting on pretty well now for a low level tame. Over a K, it's not bad. Right. So let's head to our destination and see what we can do. I hope this will work. I'm sure it will. Oh god, I'm quite encumbered. Have I got anything I can put away? Might ditch these berries and arrows. Oh, let's just drop the berries. Who cares? We got a trike. Okay, we're going to need to put these arrows away. Oh, fine. Just going to put these arrows away as well. Because it's fine at the moment, but I guess... I don't know how much weight the dung beetle is going to add, but better safe than sorry, because the Pteranodon obviously doesn't carry very much, so... I'll just chuck my arrows in here for now. We'll be lazy. I don't think I've got too much else on me that's unnecessary. The spoiled meat is kind of... Let's put some that way. We won't need all of that. That's just there in case we need it for taming. You can actually use spoiled meat for taming dung beetles as well, but it's the least efficient thing, I believe. Well, I mean, I think you can even do it with raw meat, which just takes ages, but it's one of the lesser efficient methods of taming. The most efficient is the large poops. Oh, hello, a yellow drop. Is it down? Yes, it is down. Right, oh, let's grab that. Let's see what we got. Got that saber saddle out of it. Ah, bad luck. Bad luck. It is gone. Okay. Fine. Yeah, I got that good saber saddle was out of a yellow drop. So, what's this one? That's just a crappy white one. We don't care about that. Let's keep going to Batman Island. That's right. That's where we're going to find our dung beetle. Oh, I've got something else great to show you, though. But on our way to Batman Island, you have near Batman Island, as well as this little tiny island here, you have another island. Let's fly up in the air and get a good view of that. Ladies and gentlemen, you have Penis Island. That's right. There is an island shaped like a penis and balls. So excellent. Very pleased with that addition. It does have a big rock sitting on the balls. Otherwise, fairly phallic island. So GG for that one. Or, I mean, if you're less filthy-minded, you could say it looks maybe like a butternut squash. But I am filthy-minded, so I think it looks like a cock. Right. So apparently, you can find dung beetles here, I have been told. So I'm going to have a little look for them. I'm not sure where. I guess inside somewhere. Let's get a little bit of stamina. I think you also get the spiders here as well. They're doing an update. It was due today. So, well, it's probably out by the time you watch this video. Oh, God, it's very hot here as well. This is going to be sketchy taming. Okay, but let's have a quick look before we melt. See if we can see one anywhere. Why is it going so slow? There we go. Oh god, I hope this doesn't count as a cave and suddenly kick me off my bird. That'd be a traumatic experience. Over the lava. Okay. Oh god, there's fire there. Okay, fine. Up here maybe? That's my health. That's my bird's health. That's okay, it's going down slowly. Right, we've got a bat thing. I don't see any dung boots. I did... Oh, the bat thing's attacking me. I saw a spider... Oh, hello. Right. So there might be some stuff. Oh, it's one of those cool centipede things. And that... No, that's a spider. Might not be any up here at the moment. We have to check at the cave. Yeah, that's a spider. That's one of those crazy new things that you can... that climbs up walls that you can tame. Look at that one. That is a wacky looking thing. But we just want to... We want a dung beetle. Not any of that weird stuff. Okay, let's have one little fly down inside again and just see what we can see. And then if we can't find one, maybe I'll go and check out this cave near my base. And I might have to come back here another time. I mean, I could tame a spider, could be kind of cool. I never tamed a spider before, but maybe we'll save that for another time. Right, are there any other ledges where there might be dung beetles that might have fallen down, maybe? Over in the eyes. And here, that's the bat again, that's a bat. No, it doesn't look like it, does it? Unless we've got any out on the outer edges, we might have to abandon that plan. Can we, is it cool down if I go out here? It does, lovely. I might just skim around the outskirts here. You never know, mine might have wandered off outside. Should be okay going in this cave. I need to, I'll have to grab some stim berries because it'll be full of scorpions and bloody snakes. So it's going to be a bit more sketchy than doing this, no doubt. Let's have a quick circle around the back of Batman, see if we can see anything. Yeah, I think it's a bit of a lost cause, really.
I want a dung beetle, not a bloody...
What's that? I thought I saw something down there. What's that? Oh, it's just a bit of lava sneaking through the floor. Oh, I thought that was a bloody dung beetle. Fair enough, it's not. Any other... What about in these... There's more of these guys. There's a lot of those. What's that there? Oh my god, is that... That is a dung beetle. Hello. Who are you? What level are you? Level 40. That is good. Oh, I don't know if these things get aggressive, though. I'm not sure I want to... Scrap them. Let's just go and park up out of the way and have a look. Oh god, I don't really want to fight these bats. It can be a little bit of a pain as well. Oh, very glitchy ground. Is he gonna... Yep, he's angry. Okay. I guess we can just barrel roll him, can't we? We'll barrel roll this guy and then we'll get that dung beetle. Come at me, bro. I guess I've got pretty good stamina now, so his barrel rolls are a little bit more effective. He can do it. Oh, missed that one. He can do a few in a row. I don't know what level that thing is. They do seem to need tons of high level stuff on here, so I wouldn't be surprised if it's some crazy level. Oh, missed that one. Let's get some stam. Not too quick, the bats, are they? So, Want that? Don't get it? Right, let's just go and whack it with my sword. I'm getting bored of that. Charge! What level are you? Nothing too crazy. 60. Oh, that's fine. That's fine. It's better than the level, like, 150 things you see running around. Hello. Where'd it go? Where'd it go? Right, fine. Oh my god, it's gone mental. Oh dear. Oh, the dung beetle's come out. Oh, it's a different dung beetle. Okay, oh, we got... Oh, there's two dung beetles. Fine. Look at that guy. That went nuts. Uh-oh. Doesn't sound good. I think I made it angry. I did make it angry. Anything in there? Spears. Interesting. Is he going for my pteranodon? Don't know what he's doing. Alright. Well, let's try and tame you. You're not right next to the other guys. Let's put our pink club away. Can't really tell if he's aggroed or not at the moment. I think he might be... Oh... God, I'm a bit nervous about falling through the world around here. It seems a little bit glitchy. Maybe we'll go and try the other one. This guy's in a bit of a... Look at this. He's... See you later, dung beetle. Are you aggroed? Uh-oh. I mean, normally it lets you feed them if they're not aggroed. So, oh, no, there we go. It's fine. All right, brilliant. Well, this is good. I don't have to fight with those two bloody centipede things. I just have to risk falling through the world. Oh, I've got to... So when you tame these guys, you've got to make sure you have... It's like any passive tame. You've got to make sure you have the thing to feed them in your that end slot of your inventory. And then you basically wait till it's hungry again, like it says. And then you smash another one in. And you can see the large poop there. It's given pretty big efficiency. Well, pretty big amount of feeding. It's also given it good efficiency. So get a nice amount of levels, which is good because these things tame out with a very low carry weight. Which means you can't really put much poop in them. If they had a normal big carry weight, it'd be kind of crazy. They'd be really, really... I mean, they're pretty good anyway. They're pretty damn useful. But if they had a high carry weight, it'd be ridiculous. Come on, guy. Sometimes I find it takes a while for the after the first one, it seems to take them a while, and then suddenly they're like bang, 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 and you can just throw the poop in them like a traction engine. It's It's a bit weird, the old passive taming. I haven't done too much of it. It's only these guys I've really done it much on. Lammy's done it quite a lot with the old... He likes the little monkeys. He's tamed a few of those in his time. I want to try it on the Gigantopithecus, the big ape things. I think one of those would make a really good barman for the Sneaky Beaver, so it's on the to-do list. Come on, Mike. Get hungry. It's bloody raining out here. How's my trend on? You right, mate? Brian, you okay? He seems cool. Might bring him a bit closer. I guess he's pretty chill there. It's nice they seem to come on. Is he? Why is it not saying let me feed him? It's not giving me wait till hungry again. Oh okay, fine. Oh, uh-oh. Ah, damn it. Aggroed him. Run away. Maybe a bit of a pain in the ass, these passive tames. Hopefully, normally you can just kind of run around a bit and then he'll just get de-aggroed and then stop. One of the problems you can run to, you've got to be careful when you're taming these guys. If you come and try and... Ooh, what's down there? If you just come and try and pick one up with an Arge and drop it in a taming pen and then tame it, you have to be really careful because if they get aggroed... Here we go. If you get aggroed to... one of your structures, so if you put them in a taming pen and then you aggro them, it's very likely that they'll then get aggroed to the walls, and then they kind of, there's a bit of a bug at the moment where they basically never really get de-aggroed unless you sort of smash out all the walls, or if you knock them out and then let them wake up again, that kind of fixes it. But yeah, it can be a bit of a pain. There we go, you can see after that first one, now he's like suddenly loves the poop and can't get enough of it. Hopefully he's not going to dive into the bloody sea before we can tame him. But yeah, so if you do have that problem where you've chucked one in a taming pen and then it starts attacking the walls and you can't make it stop, try tranking it out. You can knock passive animals that you passive tame, you can still knock them out. That's just not how you tame them. So you can knock him out, and then when he finally wakes up from being knocked out, he won't be aggressive anymore and you can try again. I've made him angry again, haven't I? He's blood. No. Don't run into the sea. No, come back. Oh shit, right, okay, let's get the bird. I mean, there is that other one we can go for, but I don't really want to grapple this. I'm not sure if grappling him is going to aggro him or if I can just keep him on a tether. Maybe I should try that. I mean, he's in a bit of a crappy spot right now. No. Right. I don't know what sort of nasties we're going to find in the sea around here. No, come on, get out. You chill? Oh. There we go, we got another one in. He must be nearly done. There we go, he seems to have chilled out a bit now. I think we only need one more, hopefully. Right, come on. Come on, Pooper. Do me proud. This'll do it. One more. Okay. Well, this is great. I didn't think I'd be able to get a dung beetle, and it's actually really close to the base as well. It's only just over that, I can hear him moving. It's not very far away at all to get back to the base, so... Should be pretty easy to get him back with the help of our grapple, and there we go. Let's name him up. We'll call you Pooper. It's probably not going to let me call him that, is it? Because of the bloody profanity filter. Alright, we'll call him, there we go. Shit machine. Screw you, profanity filter. We don't care for you. We will call him shit machine. Okay, so passive. He's following me. That's kind of fine. Well, we don't really need you following me. And what we need to do now, you might be wondering how I'm going to get him back. We can get our grapple and grapple him. And then we can get on the bird. And we can fly back. And we've got a dung beetle. We've got a shit machine dangling from Brian. And we can take him home. There we go. Oh, that worked a treat, didn't it? Bit of a scare. I thought I was going to find one. And we end up finding two. Almost lost him into the sea, but shit machine decided to pull it back and be a bit more of a team player. And I've got some pretty sweet bronze armor. So, / tangerine. Yeah, I'm pleased with that. So it's always nice to have a little orbit cam when you're dragging something along. Whee! Oops, is he alright? He's fine. do have to be careful when I'm doing that, because I have no idea what my stamina is. Don't want to lose poor old Chip Machine to a Pteranodon stamina mishap. Here we go, we're back. The Brontos are still here. It's Bronto carnage. Jesus, they're everywhere. Bloody hell. These guys got a Stego tamed already. Or was that just the trike I saw earlier? No, it's just a trike. Very nice. Oh, Brontosaurus. It's weird that you get Parasithiums as well. Paras, the big, like, giant fat giraffe things you get in the swamp, because we're nowhere near the swamp, but you do seem to get them around, which is cool, because I kind of want to tame one of those. I want to try building, like, a little one, maybe with, I don't know, with, like, fridges or something on the back. Here we go. It's just a pop Chip Machine down. And pop off, and then I believe we just do a little squat. There we go. And he is now good to roam. Wicked. So we just got to chuck some poop in him. There we go. He can only fit one. And you can see what I mean about the low weight. He's only got 6.3 weights. So we can only fit one in. Oh, I could fit one of my own personal poops in there as well. And then we just got to put him on Wander. And he'll slowly turn that into fertilizer. So that is top notch. You're going to Wander. Oh, he's encumbered as well, I guess. So, but as long as he's on Wander, there we go. He will gradually turn that into fertilizer and also into oil, which would be really handy. No doubt, within 5 minutes, he'll find a way to glitch through the walls. Thanks, Ark, and disappear. But we'll see. We'll see. At least it's not far to go if we do want to get another one. So we want to get that fertilizer so we can grow these carrots and these lemons so we can make some kibble. Although we've only got one male Dillo so far. So I'll probably go offline, off video, off camera, and get a few more Dillos and stuff and a few more Dodos. The good thing, one of the other good things about having this little community we've got here is that because you always have people nearby, the area is always loaded in, so the eggs are always popping out. So whenever I come online, basically, it's pretty likely there's going to be like a heap of eggs for me to pick up, unless someone's sort of flown in and pinched them, which I don't mind too much. But yeah, it's pretty good. And because of the taming speed, you only need about nine dodo kibble for a max level Pteranodon, so pretty crazy, really. Some of the others are a bit more sensible. Be nice if you could increase taming speed without affecting the amount of kibble. That's the thing that bugs me. I don't mind the amount of kibble you have to produce. I just mind the, I don't have time to do sort of 4 or 5 hour, well, big tames. It's nice to have the tames at sort of half an hour to an hour. It's a bit better for video, so, but I wouldn't mind using the full amount of kibble. So it's a little bit of a shame it reduced the kibble so much. That makes it a little bit easy. But there you go, what can you do? Alright, nice one. Well, I think that's a good stopping point. We managed to successfully go and fetch Ship Machine from Batman Island, and we also managed to paint our armor a very fetching bronze color. So, yeah, pretty chuffed with that. Nice one. Alright, well, thanks for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed the episode, feel free to hit that like button. It does really help us out, and we appreciate that. And make sure you're subbed to the channel so you can check out the rest of the stuff. Nice one. Alright, my name's Ben. We are the Beard Guys, and I'll see you next time.